Evening of January 1950, Aapti and Mehak are sitting at Natu's tea stall.
Hello friends! As you all know, today is 26th of January, which is Republic Day. Me and my friends are here to perform a small skit based on this day. There are four main characters and they are Aapti, Anu, Mehak and Dakshita. Hope you will enjoy it. So without any lag or further ado, let's get started. Sit back and enjoy.
Nagu Kaka, one tea please.
Hi Dakshita, how are you? Come and have tea with me.
Yeah, Aapti Chachi, this is the only saving grace in this cold weather.
Natu Kaka, please make us a fresh hot tea, will you?
What a refreshing tea. You must have met my daughter, Mehak. Say namaste to your behen, Mehak.
Namaste, Behenji.
Namaste. How are you doing? Are you going to school?
Yes, Behenji. It is so much fun to go to school. Teachers tell us a lot of stories about great Mahatma Gandhiji, Nehru ji, Subhash Chandra Bose ji and many such freedom fighters. It's very inspiring.
Chachi, do you realize it's been more than 2 years we got independence and we are still being governed by old British rules. Isn't it distressing?
Yeah, you are right. But our leaders were discussing the nitty-gritties of the framework that will govern an independent country. Wonder what happened?
They surely said something about forming a drafting committee to draft our own constitution. But I'm not sure what happened to that. I'm already losing hope.
Drafting committee? What's a drafting committee?
A very good question indeed, Mehak. With the post-declaration of our independence, the Constituent Assembly elected a set of leaders to form a drafting committee on 29th August 1947. This drafting committee was given the task of making a set of laws which will govern our new country. This set of laws together was called our Indian Constitution.
Oh, but it's already more than 2 years, you said. Haven't they not yet completed drafting the commission? It's been awfully long, isn't it?
Yeah, we fought so valiantly and we are still being ruled under the Government of India Act 1935 made by British Empire. What a tragedy!
Well, Mehak has a point. Chachi, do you remember the news about constitution being signed a couple of months back in November 1949 itself? Why is it not declared or implemented or brought into force till now?
Hey Aapti!
Hello Dakshita!
What are you two discussing? And who is that little one? Mehak, how are you girl?
Namaste Chachi!
Namaste, and Chachi, we were talking about a new constitution.
Oh yes, what a wonderful creation, a constitution. Aapti, Dakshita, why are you two looking so sad? It is the start of another new year. Now we are in 1950. I never thought in the January of 1930 that I would live to see an independent India 20 years down the line. The smell of independent India is so different, refreshing, wow.
January 1930? What happened in that year?
Oh, you were too young then, Dakshita. Mehak was not even born. But we clearly remember that day, don't we, Anu?
Oh, yes. Still feel the energy of that day. You see, on 26th January 1930, we India declared Purna Swaraj, the famous declaration of Kalka. complete independence of India from the imperialist British rule. That day still gives me goosebumps. What a day that was.
But Chachi, what did this Purna Swaraj mean? The British rulers were still in India. So how could we declare independence unilaterally?
Aarti, your daughter is awfully intelligent. She always asks the right question. Mehek, on 22nd January 1930, International Congress declared independence of India from the cruelty of British rule. Purna Swaraj, a complete self-rule. The country celebrates this day as an Independence Day ever since, that is, till we got independent from British in 15 August 1947. Now we are able to breathe freely in our own independent country without any outsider ruling us. What a day that was. It really feels like a dream now.
But Anu Chachi, we are still following the rules made by Britishers. We are not entirely independent, are we?
Be patient, my dear, be patient. Take a step at a time. At that time, we need to move the British out of India and get our country in our own hands. Making laws take time. We are a diverse country. We need to have a lot of discussions and debates to adopt a perfect set of rules which are acceptable by all in the society. However, you must be aware that the Constituent Assembly have finalized and signed our constitution in last year November, that is 26 November 1949.
But Anu Chachi, when will we see our own constitution taking effect? I just hate the discriminatory British laws.
Haven't you heard in the news that we are going to adopt our constitution any time now?
What? Wow! I think missed it. What is that going to happen?
By now, you must have guessed that we are commemorating 20 years of declaration of Purna Swaraj by adoption of our signed constitution.
Bharat Mata Ki Jai, Vande Mataram.
Dr. C. Rajagopalachari. Whereas the people of India, having into a sovereign democratic republic, adopted, enacted and gave to themselves on the 26th day of November 1949 in their Constituent Assembly, the Constitution of India. And whereas it has been declared by the said constitution that India, that is Bharat, shall be a union of states comprising within the union the territories which were hitherto the governor's provinces, the Indian states and the chief commissioner's provinces. And whereas this, the 26th day of January 1950 has been fixed for the commencement of the said constitution. Now, therefore, it is hereby proclaimed that from this date, the 26th day of January 1950, India, that is Bharat, shall be a sovereign democratic republic, and the union and its component units, the states, shall exercise all powers and functions of government and administration in accordance with the provisions of the said constitution. Thank you and have a nice day.